Jonathan Chase, the hypnotist. Can hypnosis force you to do things against your will, things that you wouldn't normally do? Let's apply a little bit of logic here. You get somebody who would normally, when they're stressed, have a panic attack. It's their natural, their normal state of being. They've been doing it for years and years and years. I can hypnotize them and create a situation where that doesn't happen anymore. Yeah, I can get them to do something else instead. And because that's productive, that's ignored as being getting you to do something that you wouldn't normally do. For instance, if you would normally in a situation panic and I get you to rub the side of your nose and take 3 deep breaths instead, that's seen as a positive thing and that isn't making you do something that you wouldn't normally do. What people mean is, would people who are hypnotized be put into a situation where they would, say, do harm to other people or to themselves? Now, the interesting thing is that there's a little book here called, it's one of my favourites, called Modern Hypnosis. And in Modern Hypnosis, there's one experiment. Will hypnotized persons try to harm themselves or others, which was conducted by Lloyd W. Rowland, PhD, the University of Tulsa, which proved categorically that you can get people to harm themselves or others without too much effort. Can you be forced to do something that would go against your deeply held morals, beliefs or values? No, but you can be cajoled and persuaded to do most things. And certainly in a hypnotic situation, you can be cajoled and persuaded that that would be a good idea. If I wanted you to kill somebody, what do I have to do? I give you a gun and then I persuade your subconscious mind that that person has done something so reprehensible, so disgusting, and that their only punishment is you pointing the gun and pulling the trigger. And anyway, I've hypnotized you and told you that there are no bullets in the gun. It's only going to give him a fright and all the other things. You'd do it. But then again, you'd probably do that with a good manipulation anyway, with a charismatic person anyway. You've only got to look at wars. It happens all the time. Religions, it happens all the time. So please don't think that because when you hypnotize, you're immune to just being persuadable. Of course you are. Now, these are opinions. They're my opinions, they're hypnotic opinions from a hypnotist that's been one for a long time. I teach hypnosis. If you go along to learn-hypnosis.com, that's learn-hypnosis.com, I'll give you some more of these, and you can rant, you can rave, you can send me letters, you can hypnotize people and get them to come and shoot me, whatever you want to do. But no, don't do that. But seriously, on a more serious level, you know, you really do have to recognize that human beings are capable of doing lots of stuff. Come along, I'll give you some more of these videos. I'll give you 20 of these videos. There might even be more by now, I don't know. But I'll give you 20 of these videos, the short, succinct. And they're the other side of hypnosis. If you disagree with me, there's a comments box, leave a comment. Rate the video, rate it as poor, rate it as puerile, rate it as fantastic, but let me know you're there.